You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host, and today I have the pleasure to have Sean Merrill from Teen Challenge right here in Brockton. Be my guest. Welcome, Sean.
Thanks, Mark.
It's nice to see you.
Good to be here.
You guys do great things. You help people every day. You have a nice facility over on the south side of Brockton, which is better than the rest of the south side of Brockton that needs some help. But you've taken your headquarters, you guys have expanded, you brought in new programs. We're going to talk about Teen Challenge in a separate segment as a whole, kind of non-dated, but we want to promote your great event that you're doing, and it's later than now, it's August, yeah. And it's in October. Hear Their Cry, which is your banquet.
Yes.
Let's talk about it.
Yeah, so like you said, with Teen Challenge doing so many great things, the best thing, though, in my opinion, is when I came into the program in 2014, I came in without a dollar to my name. And about 90% of the people that come to our program have burnt all their bridges. We don't receive any government funding. We're all private. The cost of our program is $750 a month. It's not much, but when you're struggling with addiction, you usually burnt all your bridges and you can't afford that. 90% of the people that come into our program can't. That's where these events come in and why it's so exciting to me. These events are the fundraisers that enable us to do that.
Well, I was at last year's event, and it was a great event. I was right, dead center, right up front. I was very impressed with the number of people that came to support it. Businesses bought full tables.
Yeah.
There were people there to help, and it was inspiring.
Yeah.
To me.
It is. When you see the people that were once broken and struggling with addiction and then have their lives transformed and overcome, and that's what we highlight at the banquet. We show some of those transformed lives. We share some testimonies. The guys will get up on stage and sing. When you put us up on stage by ourselves, we don't sound so great. But when you put us with 15 or 20 other guys, we make a joyful noise. It's very inspiring. It's a very moving event.
And you do not just the banquet, but every week there's services.
Yeah.
I've seen them. They've been live on, everything's internet-based now.
Yeah.
Okay. Not live on cable. People don't watch traditional channels the same way. Social media. The event is October 13th. Let's talk about the event specific.
So it's actually, I don't know if you remember, it's actually going to be October 13th and 14th.
That's right.
We've already sold over 200 seats to the Saturday evening. Our capacity for comfortably seating people in banquet style at Teen Challenge Brockton is 450 people. We've already sold 200 seats. And so as we did last year we sold out the Saturday night about a month in advance. So then we opened up Sunday night. We made a second event. And we said, hey, if anybody comes to it, great. We ended up selling another 250 seats for Sunday night. So we're going ahead and we're planning on doing that again this year. We're going to do the Saturday night banquet and the Sunday night banquet, October 13th and 14th.
Just made my day because that weekend's already a busy weekend over here, and we want to be there to cover it. I want to be there to support it. I know you've worked with Larry and Peg Curtis, who do the Deadly Silence show here over on cable TV. And you guys work pretty much with everybody. You have elected officials that are supportive of what you do. And again, it is all private funds. It's not public funds. There's no taxpayer dollars going to this. And you think about it, when people go in for treatment, they don't have an extended stay.
No.
They barely scratch the surface from what I understand.
Yeah.
And it doesn't end when they've gone out of the treatment facility, because if there aren't resources there to help people, they might relapse and go right back.
Right. Yeah, it's not a short-term thing that you can just quickly fix. It's a long-term process. And so our program's 15 months long. But after you graduate the program, you have an option to do an additional 6 months for an apprenticeship. And then even after that, you become part of the Teen Challenge Alumni Network. Which we're going to stay connected with you, just like a college alumni would, for the rest of your life. And you're part of the Teen Challenge family.
So they're going to get good food.
Incredible food.
Okay, and you guys do catering.
Yeah.
As part of what you do. You turn, people's lives around and give them skills that they need to, when they get out. Like you said, a lot of people come in without a dollar to their name, and they may have had some skills, or they may have been in the middle of a program, but when they get hit with addiction,
Sure. So I'm glad you brought that up, because part of the fundraising for this year's banquet, what we're going to be doing, is we just built two more buildings on our campus. We built a mechanic shop mm-hmm. and a maintenance shop, a carpentry type of shop. With on the upstairs, the second floor of each of those is classrooms. And so what we're hoping to do, we're believing we're going to be able to do, is get certified vocational training on our campus. So while you're going through the program, you'll not only be learning how to live life drug-free and getting your family restored and redeemed and all of those great things, but while you're doing the things like the kitchen ministry, like the automotive ministry, like the carpentry and electrical and plumbing ministries, you'll be able to have some classroom time where you're going to get some vocational training, so that when you graduate the program, you're not leaving with just only your sobriety and a new life, but you're leaving with a career.
A skill.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to go back to the banquet, because we're going to do the whole second segment about, generic.
Okay.
More generic. Tickets. How do people get tickets?
Tickets. You can get tickets online at hearthercry.org.
Okay.
Or you can call Dylan at 774-480-5716.
Dylan.
D-I-L-L-O-N.
Okay.
We off the air.
Okay. No, we're on here.
Okay.
No, I'm just making sure we're not live, but we're live to record.
Gotcha.
I can't even say live to tape anymore. That's how long I've been doing this. I like the theme, Hear Their Cry, because people going through addiction or people that are around people going through addiction, sometimes their cries are in silence.
Yeah.
Sometimes as close as you are as a family member, you might not see the signs. You educate. You guys educate people too.
Yeah.
Okay. But it is a ministry. You said ministry.
Yep.
Okay. And you have to obviously believe in God to.
It's not a prerequisite.
It's not a prerequisite.
Nope.
Okay. Well, I know Masons are.
We're going to strongly recommend it.
Okay.
And we believe that through the process of the program, through you seeing other people that have come to faith and have changed their lives, that you will too. Mm-hmm. But no, we don't ask you to be a believer coming into the program. We just ask that you have an open mind and you be willing to be open and to want to change your life.
How is it paid for? Okay, it's not a government thing, so
yeah.
it's not government health insurance. It's basically through the fundraising.
Well, right, exactly. The guys that come to our program has MassHealth, so they get covered
right.
medically, but that doesn't cover our program. MassHealth
right.
doesn't pay for it. No, we have, like I said, the ministries. We do things like the catering, like the maintenance, but the banquets, the golf tournaments, the 5Ks. We have churches and businesses all throughout the community that send us money monthly that really want to help. And so, the theme, Hear Their Cry. Like, one thing I love about the city of Brockton is that from every level of politician to level of the member of the community, they're so supportive of our program. They make monthly donations. They just anything we need. There we have a list of 236 volunteers.
Wow.
That are willing to volunteer anytime.
I'm going to cut you short this
yes.
time. We're going to bring you back.
Okay.
But thank you for being here, and we're going to be there to promote everything you do all the way.
Thanks, Mark.
You're welcome. You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.